Okay, so in today's class, we are going to discuss about instruction set of PIC microcontroller. As already we know that PIC microcontroller is a RISC type of microcontroller which uses a reduced number of instruction set. So one of the important feature of a RISC system is that those will have a fixed length instructions. So here is in 18 series PIC microcontroller, we have a highly orthogonal fixed length instructions of 16 bit wide. So these instructions is classified based on the operations they perform. So like byte oriented operations, bit oriented operations, literal operations and control operations. Byte oriented operations means an instruction that performs operations on a byte. Bit oriented means instructions that perform a bitwise operation such as logical operations like AND or XOR or even maybe complementing or inverting a bit. So like that. So various bitwise operations can be performed using PIC instructions. So and then literal operation instructions means an instructions that is used to load the data into a working register. And an instructions there are special instructions, so that is used to control the operations of PIC microcontroller. And also there are a group of instructions called table instructions, so that can be useful for implementing two-dimensional table or type of data that can be handled using a table handling instructions. So as we know that each microprocessor and microcontroller family has its own instruction set. So like that, PIC is also having its own instruction set. So first we will look at the byte oriented instructions. So most byte oriented instructions have a three operands. So unlike other x86 family of microprocessor or other microcontroller family, already you have seen like 8051. So here PIC microcontroller instructions, assembly language instructions, will have a up to three operands. So usually x86 family microprocessor, already you study madronge adralli bari erad operand irthittu, one source matte destination. But for this PIC instructions, you have to specify three operands. That means each assembly language instruction has a three operand part. So first part is the file register, that is denoted by a letter F. The next part is the destination of the result, which is specified by a letter D. And the third operand part is the access memory. So as we know that PIC microcontroller is having a up to 2 kilobytes of RAM. Up to 4 kilobytes of RAM. So that RAM is divided into 256 bytes of 16 memory banks. So you have to access any of these storage locations from the these memory banks. So you can use any bank from bank 0 to bank 15. So combinedly bank 0 and bank 15, they have made a one special bank called access bank. So without the use of bank select register, you can access that access bank memory locations. So that is specified by the word accessed memory. So that is denoted by a letter. I will explain the instruction with the example in the next slide. The file register denotes for a F. Specify the which file register is to be used by the instruction. That means for each instruction, you have to specify the operand where it will be. So as I told that this PIC microcontroller is a RISC processor, one of the important feature of a RISC system is that it is a load store type of architecture. That means if you want to process any data, that has to be bring back into the internal registers. So then it has to be processed by the CPU. So here in this PIC microcontroller, we have a built-in RAM. So that built-in RAM memory location itself act as a register set. So in any operation, which data you are operating, that data's memory address you have to specify in the instruction. So because this is a PIC microcontroller is a RISC system, it has a limited addressing mode support. So for the most of the instructions, operand is specified as a direct address or indirect address. So for indirect addressing, we use the FSR register, that is called as file select register. So in that FSR register, indirectly we can specify the memory location address of a RAM, So that will be used as a register. Or directly you can specify the 8-bit memory address in the instruction. The destination designator D specify where the result of the operation is to be placed after an instruction has been executed. So as I told that there will be up to three operands. So destination operand will specify where data has to be stored, whether it has to be stored in the accumulator like register called working register in the PIC microcontroller, or it has to be stored in the file registers. So that is specified by the letter D. So if D is zero, the result is placed in the WREG register. WREG register is a working register that is like an accumulator. So as we know that accumulator is a special register that will hold the result of a most of the instruction in x86 family of microprocessor or and other controller devices. So here we won't have any accumulator. Here we have a working register. So whether you want to place the result in the working register or you want to place the result in the memory, so that is specified by the letter D, that is the operand part of the instruction. If D is zero or D is one, the result is placed in the file register specified in the instruction. So here is the list of PIC microcontroller instructions. So already nimga assembly language instructions ni 8086 microprocessor instruction study madidira. So like that, here also we have a assembly language instruction that has a mnemonics and operands. So the mnemonics here we are using for PIC microcontroller will be little bit different than that of the 8086 microprocessor. So and also here you have to specify three operands. So you can see the first instruction. So here you see that an instruction called ADDWF. This is stands for add working register with working register content with the file register. So you have to specify the file register, which file register you want to add to the working register, and then you have to specify the D. So D is a single bit operand. It will specify where result has to be placed. If it is zero, result will be placed in the working register. If D is one, then result will be placed in the F, that is the memory location you are specifying in the instruction. And A will indicate memory location you are specifying the instruction, which is from the either any of 16 banks which is pointed by the BSR register, or it is a memory location that is accessed by the access bank. So that is specified by the third operand A. So A is again a single bit operand. So here I will show the example. So you can see there is an instruction add W F F comma D comma A. So this is the syntax of an add instruction. So here F will specify the file register designator, D specify the destination designator, and if D equal to zero, result will be placed in the working register. D equal to one, result will be placed in the file register. So and similarly, there is a letter A in the syntax of that add instruction. So if A equal to zero, BSR is ignored. BSR means bank select register. In that bank select register, there are four bank select bits. In you have to select any of the 16 bank, so from 0 to 15. So this bank's register will be ignored, and the memory location which is pointed in the instruction will be assumed as a, which is taken from the access bank. So I already have explained about data memory organization of PIC microcontroller. So access bank means it is a combination of lower memory address of the bank 0 and higher memory address of the bank 15. So combinedly will act as a access bank. So whichever the memory address you are specifying in the instruction, if letter A is zero means, so it will consider that the memory location is taken from the access bank. So if A equal to one, then that instruction will assume that the memory location you are pointing in the instruction will be taken from the memory bank which is pointed by the BSR register. So here you can see the actual instruction, that add instruction, add WF 23 comma 1 comma 0. So that means this instruction will perform the addition operation. It will add the content of memory location 23 and it will be added with the working register, and result will be placed in the memory location 23. So Here you can see in the syntax of this instruction, the third operand is zero. Third operand is a that will specify the which memory bank you are accessing. If a equal to zero means you are accessing a data from the access bank. So 23 memory address you are specifying in the instruction. That 23 is taken from the access bank. That is the lower memory address of the bank zero. So from that 23 memory location, data will be taken and that will be added to the working register content and result will be stored in the 23H memory location again, which is in the access bank. So again, you can see the same instruction written in other way. That is add WF 23H 0, 0. So here for the first instruction, the destination designator is 1. So D is 1. So here D is 1 means result will be placed in the file register. If D is 0 means same operation will be performed, but result will be placed in the working register. So are you understanding the difference between these two instruction? Hello? Hello?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Artha aagtidya instruction syntax na heltirodu?
Sir, artha aagtidya.
So add WF andre, this instruction will perform the addition operation. So what actually it is adding? The content of memory location pointed in the instruction and the working register content. So result will be placed either in the working register or in the memory location. So that is dependent on the destination designator you are specifying the instruction. A destination designator 1 is andre, so result will be placed in the memory location. Destination designator is 0 means result will be placed in the working register. And again, that letter A in the syntax of PIC assembly language instruction will specify which bank, memory bank you are accessing in the instruction. So A equal to 0 andre, access bank memory location access madate. If A equal to 1 andre, third operand is 1 means memory location which is specified in the instruction is taken from the memory bank specified by the BSR. BSR stands for bank select register. So one instruction explain madadre sakalva artha agutalva? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Same thing will be applied for all other instructions. So you can see next instruction, that is add WFC. So this instruction is similar to the add with carry. So syntax now usually 86 instruction nodadaga illi WF anta na word en use martilla ADC anta use martidre add with carry instruction ge illi a mnemonics alli spellings difference ide. So because this PIC microcontroller is a different family of microcontroller, so it has its own instruction set. They have specified its own syntax for the assembly language instructions. So this add WFC instruction will perform the adding the content of working register with the file register along with the carry. So next third instruction is the AND WF. AND WF stands for logical AND operation with the content of working register with the memory location and result where it has to be specified. You have to specify in the instruction. So destination 0 idre result enide adu working register alli irutte. So destination bit 1 is andre memory location. Okay. So next instruction is the CLRF. So this is a clear instruction. So the whatever the memory location you specify in the instruction, that will be cleared, that memory location. You got 25H and the memory location specify madre, our memory location content will be initialized to 0 or cleared to 0. So next COMF. COMF stands for complement F. That means memory location F content will be complemented. Complemented means 0 will be replaced by 1 and 1 will be replaced by 0. So under invert agatha. And result will be placed in the according to instruction destination designator. Destination designator 1 is under result file register layeratha. So otherwise it will be in the working register. So default result will be placed in the working register. You just remember that one. So working register is like an accumulator in any other microcontroller or microprocessor. So next instruction is the CPFSEQ. So that means compare F with working register, skip if equal. So this instruction I will actually will perform the two operations. One is comparison operation, another one is a branching operation. So it compares the content of working register with the file register. If both the register values are same, then it will skip the next instruction. It will go to the subsequent instruction after the next instruction. So it will make a branching. So jump instruction use martidvi alva 8086 microprocessor le ade tara ide illi ee instructions enide compare instruction idu one instruction matra skip madutte only one byte one word of instruction. You have to remember here that each word of instructions of PIC microcontroller is 16 bit wide. So next instruction is the CPFSGT, that means compare F with working register, skip if it is greater than. So F matte working register content na compare madutte result enide a comparison result true agidre so it will skip the next instruction. If that comparison result is false, it will execute the next sequential instruction and it will continue to execute. So similarly we have a CPFSLT, that is compare F with working register, skip if less than. So andre syntax enide solpa complex ide compared to the 8086 microprocessor. So but you have to be aware of these mnemonics, what actually these operations are, these instructions are performing. So next instruction is the DECF. DECF stands for decrement F. So this is like a decrement instruction. Ali DEC jothege F add agide syntax alli. So next DECFSZ. So this is stands for decrement F, skip if zero. So this is again will perform two operation. One is decrementing the content of file register, and it will perform a skip operation if the if the result after decrementation decrementing a file register value is zero. So next DCFSNZ, decrement F, skip if not zero. So again this will perform a decrement operation and it will make a branching operation if the result after